y minus z into p plus y square into z minus x into q equal to z square into x minus y. Okay. Now, is it in the standard format? Is it in the standard format? Yes. Yes or no? Please, yeah. This is in the standard format, which is called as Lagrange's linear equation. So when it is in this standard format, let us apply and find out the auxiliary equation. So if you want, write down what are capital P, Q, R. Capital P is what? Coefficient of small p, that is x square into y minus z. Q is y square into z minus x. And R is z square into x minus y. Let us write auxiliary equations. These are dx upon p, dy upon q, and dz upon r. Now, if you take any two sets, first you need to think of simple thing. What is that? If you take the first two sets, can you get rid of z easily? Think about it. Can you get rid of, can you cancel z easily? Say either yes or no.
No.
No, it is difficult because you cannot cancel this z. It is like minus z here. It is z and multiplied with different quantities. So if it fails, even you can observe there is a symmetry. It is even going to observe for any two set. If so, what is to be done then? If it is not possible with any two fractions, any two auxiliary equations, what has to be done? We need to choose
multipliers.
Oh, okay. Choosing the multipliers. Yeah, just see what are the multipliers. To take it, I'll just take this part and just explain. Because sometimes it is difficult. We cannot guess. Okay, so what I will do better, I'll multiply and take. So if I multiply, it is x square y minus x square z. Similarly, y square z minus y square x, correct? If I multiply here, it is z square x minus z square y. Okay. Now, I would have cancelled the xy term, but this is x square y and similar type of term is y square x. So this power is troublesome. Am I right? This power should be what to cancel these two terms? Power should be? Means these two terms should be same. Here it is x square y, it is y square x. If I want to cancel it, what has to be done for this? No? No idea? See, I want
multiply.
Multiply. If you multiply, power will increase. I want to decrease the power. How can I decrease the power? Divide. So this term to be divided by what? So that I can cancel x, y. Obviously x. So divide by x, or you can say multiply by 1 by x. Am I correct? Similarly, what I have to do for this second one?
1 by y.
1 by y. So obviously, if you just observe, there is a symmetry. What should be the for the last?
1 by z.
1 by z. So these are the first set of multipliers. Let us take it. 1 by x, 1 by y, 1 by z. Means take for the first term 1 by x, multiply by 1 by x, denominator also multiply by 1 by x. See what happens if I multiply by 1 by x, numerator. Dx upon x. Here if I multiply by x, 1 by x means I am actually dividing by x, isn't it? So one of the x will be cancelled. Correct? What will you get then? What will you get here? XY?
XZ.
Minus XZ. If I, for the second one, you have to take the second multiplier, 1 by y. What will get then? Here, dy upon y. Correct? This to be divided by y. Am I right? If I divide by y, one of the y will be cancelled again. Tell me, what are the terms? If you just cancel one of the y and multiply.
Yz, yx.
Very good. Yz minus yx. Here, dz upon z, divide by z means one of the z cancels, you will get zx minus
zy.
So what you are doing, you are choosing these are the multipliers, so you should take it as a plus in between. Okay? Confirm whether the denominator becomes 0, yes or no?
Yes.
Yes. So even directly what you can write the next step, no? This numerator equal to 0, they will not cut any marks. But let me just write this. So if you just cancel the terms, denominator becomes 0. So what this implies? Numerator is 0. That is dx upon x plus dy upon y plus dz upon z is 0. How it is 0, I explained yesterday. A by b equal to c by 0. So if you transfer a 0, c becomes what? 0. That is what I am writing. Yeah. Can we integrate it? Can we integrate it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, we can. Okay. Yes. So along with the dx, dy, dz, you should have function of x, y, z only, not the other pi. So what is the integration of 1 by x with respect to x?
Log x.
Log x. Next term?
Plus log y.
Plus?
Log z.
Log z is equal to what I have to write? Log of c1. Apply the property. What do you get? Log of x plus log of y log z is what? Log of
x, y, z
is equal to log c1. Else, from this, what is c1? C1 is x, y, z. Okay. Yeah. So first only we confirm we cannot do with any pair means next again we have to choose another set of multipliers. Another set of multipliers. See the denominator part and just tell me what multipliers can be chosen. Okay, I'll just give you one clue over here. Let's see the bracket what you have for the denominators. If you add those brackets, what is the value? If this bracket, only these brackets if you add, what is the value?
Zero,
right? So ultimately we want a zero only. So that means here you are adding only the bracket means what should be the outside quantity? Outside it should be one.
One.
How can I make this as one?
Divided by x square, y square.
Very good. Yes. So multipliers are 1 by x square, 1 by y square, 1 by z square. This is what you have to do, little rough work and decide about it. They should be either functions of x, y, z in order or they should be constant. That's all. So what we decided now, 1 by x square, 1 by y square and 1 by z square are the multipliers. So if they are the multipliers, just see what will get the numerator. Dx upon x square plus dy upon y square plus dz upon z square. Shall I write directly 0? You know the step. Directly 0 or I have to show it? Your choice. Your choice. Because
zero.
Even though if you have written correct multipliers and if you have written directly 0, they will not cut any marks. Need not to worry. This is for verification. Okay. Yeah. What should be the next step for this? Anybody has any confusion here if I have written directly 0? Hopefully no. Now integration is the next step. What is the integration of 1 by x square?
Minus 1 by x.
Very good. 1 by minus 1 by x. Similarly, minus 1 by y, minus 1 by z. Take it a constant as minus c2. Don't take minus 1 by c2. Otherwise, you will get confusion which type of equation should be written. Better. You just take minus c2. Isn't it all terms are negative? What can be written here? What is c2? 1 by x plus 1 by y plus 1 by z. Yeah, we got two relations. What is the last step? General solution. How it should be written? First relation, comma, the second one. Equal to zero. Hope the example is clear. Okay. Take on the similar lines, take one example. The only change outside instead of the square quantities, you have them as x, y, z. So I'll just discuss about it and leave. Can you tell me what are the multipliers? See, this is similar to the just now solved example.
1 by x.
Very good. 1 by x, 1 by y, 1 by z is the first set. You know how to do it and all. Tell me another set.
LM.
Isn't it? If you just add it, it is going to become zero. Just see xy.
Yes.
Minus
yes.
x.
Yes.
So if it is just adding ones, you to take it as 111. Got it? Take it as 111 means you will get dx plus dy plus dz. So integration of what is dx plus, okay, that problem is going to come here. One more example similar to that. So this is first set, this is the second set. So either they should be constant or functions of x, y, z. Don't choose first multiplier as a function of y, z. That is wrong. You cannot integrate. Second, it should be function of y only, not x, z. Got it? Similarly, the last one. Yeah, write the last, next example, not the last. Write the next example. Usually minus troubles us, but in this example, plus is going to trouble. Let's see, y plus z into p, z plus x into q equal to x plus 1. Tell me, is it in standard form, yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, so go ahead. Write what are PQR and then we'll solve it. What is the next step? Auxiliary equations. So auxiliary equations are dx upon p, dy upon q, dz upon r. See, in the previous example, 3 were positive, 3 were negative, so that adding has made it as 0. Now, what are the signs of all the terms here? Isn't it all are positive? Positive is dangerous, right? Nowadays. Am I right? Okay, so now we'll apply some properties for this. See, I'm going to apply the property like this. If a by b is equal to c by d, then if I taking a plus c, what I should write in denominator?
B plus d.
B plus d. Isn't it? Can I write it as a minus c divided by? What do you get? If I'm taking a minus c divided by?
B minus d.
B minus d. Yeah, these are some properties. So even this is equal to this, this is even equal to this. Anything you can equate. So here you cannot choose any multipliers because it is very difficult. If I choose one of them as negative, only two terms are negative. You can cancel at the most four terms. Remaining two positive will remain as it is. So no other option other than property. So let us apply. So first what I'm going to do is, if suppose if I add it, what happens? If I add all, dx plus dy plus dz. Can you tell me what is the denominator? If I do like this, denominator also should be added up.
Huh? 2x, 2y, 2z.
Yes, very good. So 2 times x plus y plus z. Now, if I want, if I suppose want to see this denominator, if it was becoming 0, I would have integrated the step. But is it 0? It is not 0. Means I need to equate here, something has to be there. Got it? In the previous example, you can observe here the denominator was becoming 0. So no problem, you could get some equation. But the situation is not like that here. So what we have to do, you try to get another relation so that it becomes easy to integrate. Okay. See, if I'm having only x, can I do the integration? I should have x equal to some 2. Then I can do an integration. Am I right? So I'm interested in one more. Tell me what property can be applied so that we can get a simple form. Okay. I'll just try with that. I use this property. I'll just tell you one clue. Again, I'm going to use this. What can be used? If I minus everything, no, I cannot. So one thing, see, this is plus z is there. If it is minus z, what happens? Isn't it plus and minus z will go? You will have in terms of only x and y. Am I correct? Tell me what to do for that. Try to get my point. This is z, you cannot cancel. But if I, this is plus z and this is minus z, then this can be cancelled, correct? So what property you are applying for this?
Dx minus.
Very good. Dx minus dy. So take the difference of these two ratios, because it's even equal to difference. So what you'll get? Y plus z minus dy, means here also you should multiply by minus. Minus z minus x. Again, if I take only 2, I'll get one relation. How is our solution? Is it phi of u equal to 0 or u comma v equal to 0?
U comma v.
U comma v. That means we require one more such relation. Okay. So for that, I'll try to take one more ratio in a similar way. Okay. Tell me what can be done. What can be used?
Dy minus dz.
Very good. Dy minus dz you can choose, or else even you can choose dx minus dz. No problem with that. Okay. Now I want only 2. Don't again go on prolonging it by taking one more. Don't want. This will help us. We want only 2 relations. Okay, take the first 2. What are the first 2? Dx plus dy plus dz divided by 2 into x plus y plus z is equal to. What is remaining in the second one? Dx minus dy upon, what you'll get here? Y minus x. Okay, so this y minus x, I'll try to write in terms of x minus y. So isn't it I have to take a minus out? Yes or no? Okay. Now just see, what is the denominator? X plus y plus z. Okay. What is the derivative of x? Derivative of x. Derivative of x is 1 if you do with respect to x. Suppose if it is not done with any variable, derivative of x is dx. Am I correct? Derivative of y is dy and derivative of z is dz. Means the situation is like this. You have 1 by f of x. You have something in the denominator and its derivative f dash is present in the numerator. How to write it? How to write such integral? What is the integration of such function?
F of x raised to n plus 1 divided by n plus 1.
Very bad, very bad. Wrong. 1 by f of x into f dash.
log of f of x.
Very good, very good. Log of denominator. This is one of the important result. Okay, I am going to use it. So we'll integrate it. So integration means I'll take 1/2 out. Isn't it? You have something in the denominator, its derivative in the numerator. This is written as log of the denominator. Check, is it the same here? Same condition here? You have denominator x minus y, derivative of x is dx, derivative of minus y is dy, isn't it? So I'll take a minus out. How to write it? How to write the integral? What is the integration of 1/x minus y into this?
Log of x minus
y. Very good. Log of x minus y. Everything in terms of log means, let us say, take adjust constant also, log c. But one thing I'll take, this is half. No, I'll just take it as half because we are just going to multiply by 2 here to simplify. Multiply by. So this becomes log of x plus y plus z. If I transfer it, it becomes plus. You are multiplying by 2. Here 1/2 cancels. Here you'll get a 2. Is equal to, again 1/2 cancels. What remain is log c2. Can you tell me what is the ultimate relation? What will get? Log a plus log b. And one more thing. How to write 2 log x minus y?
X minus y whole square. Log,
yeah,
x minus y.
Log of x minus y the whole,
x minus y whole
okay? And square. The property log a plus log b,
a into b.
Very good. Log of a into b is equal to c2, sorry, log c2. So actually we don't cancel log. It is like log a equal to log b implies a equal to b. So don't show the cancellation. That is actually wrong way of writing math. I think this is C1, no? I missed it, I guess. All are C1. No C1 is used. Okay. So this is by using the first two set among this. So you can use now first and last, or else can I use second and third? Can I use second and third?
Yes.
We can, right? Only one thing you do while taking, no, take minus common only. That is better. So here also dy minus dz, take a minus common so that it is y minus z. So if you want, cancel this minus, no problem. Can we integrate now? What is the integration of 1/2? Okay, dx minus dy upon x minus y.
Log x minus y.
Yeah, log of x minus y is equal to log of y minus z plus log of c2. So tell me directly now what is c2. You know how to apply the property. Transfer it. Log a minus log b is? Log of k by b. And just simplify. This is what you are going to get. Hope the part is clear. Transfer this. It becomes minus log. Log a minus log b is log of a by b. Last answer. This is x plus y plus z into x minus y the whole square, comma, x minus y upon y minus z is equal to 0. Is required general solution. So sometimes even the properties are useful to get the relation. Okay, they don't ask much complicated, but at least you should know the concept. Write down the next example. Tell me, is it in standard Lagrange's form or no? Is it Lagrange's linear equation?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, 100%. So let me write the auxiliary equations. See, while writing auxiliary equation, I'll take one help. That is, I'll write one step directly. This is dx upon p. So that means I have to write dx upon what it is, y minus z upon yz. So can I, what happens? 1 upon yz means?
Yz into d.
Yz comes in the numerator. So this is like yz divided by y minus z. Is it correct auxiliary equation? First one? First, okay, first part. Similarly, tell me what you'll get for the next. If you write dx upon p equal to dy upon q equal to dz upon r, what will you get?
Zx dy divided by z minus x.
Very good. Okay, similarly, xy dz upon x minus 1. Now, surely again, if you take any two set, this z can be easily cancelled, but denominator z is, we cannot because of minus. So, no other way, we have to go for what? Is it for properties or we have to go for multipliers? Think about it. One more thing, don't go for first, it is like simple way. If not possible, multipliers, then you have to go for properties. Remember like that. So what I have to apply? Easy way is not possible. What is the next step?
Multiplier.
Multipliers. Can anybody tell me what should be the multipliers? See, just see the denominator. If you just simply add, is it going to become zero?
Yes.
Yes, surely. So if you are not taking anything, if you are just straightforward taking it, multipliers are 1, 1, 1. Understood? So take them as 1, 1, 1 means what happens in the numerator? Just see. Yz into dx plus zx into dy plus xy into dz. Am I correct? 1, 1, 1. Denominator, everything cancels. Am I right? What can we write directly? Yes. This is equal to what we can write?
Zero.
Let us integrate it. Okay. This can be done in two ways. Usually what I have told that along with the dx, you should have a function of x, but you have yz extra. Similarly, the other way, two terms, the other variables are extra. This can be solved in two ways. One way, divide by x, y, z. So if you divide by x, y, z, what happens to the first term? Just observe, y, z, it will be cancelled. What remains? 1 by x dx. Isn't it? Along with the dx, you have only function of x. So easily you can integrate it. Other than that, one more way is there. Now, can you observe anything is applied here? Can you find something? Yz, then dx. Yz is kept, dx, x is differentiated. Zx is kept, y is differentiated. What is this?
Partial.
No. Not partial. Dho is not there, d is there. Which rule?
Lagrange's. No.
Not Lagrange.
Multiplication.
Multiplication rule. Isn't it? It is just the situation is like this. Can you write this as, can you write these three terms like this? Is it correct? Is it correct? So write it as derivative of xyz is equal to 0. So what we'll do for this step? What we'll do? Can we integrate it? Think about it.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, purely. What is the integration of differentiation of xyz?
Function.
XYZ.
Function only. Yes. It's not with respect to anything. It is just direct. So tell me what you will get on RHS part. C1. Yeah, I'll take it as constant. Here, if you just apply like a A division ना मैडम साइन कर रही है. ओके, इफ यू डिवाइड बाय एक्स वाई जेड नो देयर आल्सो सेम सिचुएशन लॉग एक्स प्लस लॉग वाई प्लस लॉग जेड इज इक्वल टू टेक इट एज लॉग सी वन. Then you can apply the property. That is also correct. Can anybody tell me what should be the next set? What is the next set? What's the number? And happening. Okay. Can anybody tell me what is the next set of equation, what multipliers we can take? See, you have a y minus z here. If I take here multiply by x, what happens? Xy minus xz. Here if I multiply with y, what happens? Yz minus yx.
XY.
Terms can be cancelled, right? Can I think of xyz? Check.
Yes, ultimate, yes,
denominator should become zero if you choose those multipliers. Yeah, let us use it. Choosing the multipliers. XYZ. So what do you get here? The numerator. XYZ dx, XYZ dy, XYZ dz. Am I correct? Yeah. Tell me ultimately what happens to the denominator. Isn't it all terms
zero.
Will be zero? Yeah, cancelled. So what you can write, this is equal to zero. Else, tell me what is the step to be applied here. Shall I go for an integration or one simple step I can apply here? Let me see. Who will tell? An easy way is there. What can you observe in all the terms?
Common XYZ.
Common XYZ. You take it, it is troubling you. Okay. If it was, it is troubling, better. Okay. Take common or divide by that. Your choice. Now, if I take the XYZ on the other side, isn't it? You will get dx plus dy plus dz are zero. Okay. Can we integrate now? Very easily. What is the integration of dx?
X.
X. And plus y plus z equal to what? C2. Yeah, right. That last step. General solution is phi of xyz, comma x plus y plus z equal to 0. Is the part clear? This is how we have to apply Lagrange's method and get it. So let me take next example. Write down. Z square, sorry, this is not x square. Z square minus 2yz minus y square p plus xy plus zx into q is equal to xy minus zx. xy minus zx. A little typical type it is. Yeah, it's in standard format, need not to worry. What should be the step here? You should write PQR, and important step is auxiliary equation. What is the auxiliary equation? Dx upon P. Z square minus 2yz minus y square. Can I write this as some quantity, whole square format? Just check.
Y minus z whole square.
Can we write y minus z the whole square? Surely no. See, either to write it as a plus b or a minus b, a square, b square, both should be positive. If this was plus, we would have written it as a minus b the whole square, but not now. Got it? Yeah, we cannot. So dy upon, now what I will do, what is common in these two?
X.
X, better take it so that you will get some idea. Else, okay, here also, x is common. So that you can tell me one step very easily. Let me see who will tell me that first step. Shall I go for multipliers directly or easy way it is possible? Please answer. You observe all the auxiliary equation. Tell me any simple set is there which is going to help us to solve. No? Can you see some set? Maybe 1, 2, 3 among this. Any two which are similar where we can solve it easily. Yes.
Two and three.
Yes, take it. Okay, dz upon x into y minus z. So what happens? X will be cancelled. Now what you do, actually here variables are not separated. They are again mixed format, but need not to worry because x is eliminated. Now you better cross multiply. So this is like y minus z into dy means what? Y dy minus z dy. Am I correct? Similarly, y plus z into dz means what? Y dz plus z dz. Correct? Now, you have some terms which are similar. Can anybody tell me what are they? This is y with respect, y dy, no problem. Z dz, no problem. Are they not, these two are similar? Am I right? So I'll better transfer it. This I will transfer here. So this I will take, so it becomes minus. Minus z dz. This I'll take that side. So y dz plus z dy. Can you tell me what is this RHS part here actually?
Product rule, dy z.
Yeah, it's a product rule. This side it is not problem because along with the dy you have a function of y, same thing with z here. But this is little problematic, but can be written as derivative of yz. Now can we integrate it? Can we integrate?
Yes.
Tell me, what is the integration of y with respect to y?
y square by 2.
Okay, done. Derivative of z. Okay, integration of z.
z square by 2.
Integration of derivative of yz.
yz.
Take the constant as some c1 by 2 if you want. Take it as c1 by 2. Those two terms are divided by 2. So what is c1 now? C1 can be written as y square minus z square minus 2yz. Am I correct?
2yz.
Yes, what ma'am. I did here, we are multiplying by 2 and then we are transferring terms in yz on one side, then remaining c1. I cancelled the 2.
plus.
Now it is sure one is really problematic. One is really problematic. Now what to do? We cannot do take any other two variable, two ratios here and get a relation. So only option left out now is multipliers or the properties. Think of multipliers. Any multipliers are going to help? Now it is looking actually very different and all, but actually your problems will be solved. You think of very simple multipliers. Now simply by adding, is it going to become zero? Just check. If you just add it, is it going to become zero? Surely no. Am I right? Because this is y square term, z square term. You don't have any such y square, z square term. If not possible with constant, think of x, y, z. Think of x, y, z. Is it possible? See, if I multiply by x here, it becomes x, y square. If I multiply by y here, what happens here? This x into y square, isn't it? Y square x minus y square x can be cancelled. Am I correct? Okay, let it be. Think about x, y, z. Don't think of y, z, x. You should be in order. In order means along with the dx, function of x, y, z, like that. Take these. Check what happens. X dx plus y dy plus z dz. It is little typical, but still the simple multipliers are going to help you. Confirm what happens in the denominator. Okay, multiply with x here. What will get? Xz square minus. Yeah, please tell me what you'll get. We'll get, you have written the question. Xz square minus 2yz is there, no? So 2xyz minus xy square. Am I correct with the denominator of second? First.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, now. Second, you are multiplying by y. So it is like xy into bracket y plus z means xy into y is y square plus xyz. Okay, last one. This you are multiplying by z. So it is like plus xyz minus
xz square.
Check what happens. Is it zero? Yeah, good.
Yes,
it's becoming zero. So what you'll get? X dx plus y dy. If it is very typical, no, you just think with some trial and error. That will help. Okay. Yeah. Easily we can integrate. What will get? X square by 2 plus y square by 2 plus z square by 2 equal to c2 by 2. Yeah, write that last general solution.